after that. But once again, thank you for getting on the studios again.
Yeah, thank you very much.
I know the last time we were here, we'll talk about illegal migration and a couple of other things, you know.
Yeah, irregular migration.
Okay. All right, love being on it again. I want to say welcome and we'll get you here this morning and a good morning. And nice to get you here, that shows we are playing our part.
Yeah, thank you very much and good evening to listeners out there.
I have a lot of us talk about the whole idea of temple run. But I reach a point where every blessed day, I mean, very scary, you reach a point where something come. And when it comes, some sick, some not be get nothing again, some come in case now, when I get for and give them a lot of training as we turn in. How far that project they don't go?
Well, the issue of migration, of course, IOM, first of all, now the leading migration agency, we for ensure say migration will be done in a safe an orderly manner. We need to see person for migrate, but if you migrate, you get for doing the right way. Because irregular migration, most of the time, we brothers them came back on irregular migration, then can exploit them, you know, human trafficking in kind side. For example, let we brothers and sisters, we can go to the Middle East. Most of them can exploit them. At the end of the day, they can get some of them can come back home without anything. So recently, we get a project. We, now the government of Japan, they fund that project here for see how we can reduce irregular migration to youth empowerment. Because a lot of youth them can say, we not get opportunities them at home. Now, make with the go. So we want to see how we can create the opportunities and the true skills training. So currently we work with the TVET sector, the Ministry of Technical and Higher Education. Very recently we donate some equipment to the ministry for see how we can, equip them so that they are able to carry the operation. And also we some of part of the equipment and we also donate them for some of the GTIs, the GTI in Abo and also Kailang. And beside that project, we also get another project called Migrant as Messenger. Now we use the migrants and so that themselves will tell them stories. You know, they can say he who feels it knows it. So when somebody we don't go to temple run. If you tell his story, I feel say a lot of people will believe. Because if me can now, so plenty of people will say, you know, they were another job, that something like that. But if the migrants explain his story.
Yeah, most of them don't suffer, don't go jail.
Yeah.
Some kind of
yeah.
Very sick and other things. And so.
Yeah, a lot of them. Especially there with sisters, they go Kuwait. One of them, if I can remember, they go to Kuwait. Because most of them, they can lie by them, say, we get a job for you now, this country, then they go pay you, for example, $2,000. By the end of the day, they won't even reach that. Some of them can enslave them and can face a lot of challenges where they can end up for return back home. I know of a story where one lady where they're gonna quit. In fact, they go work there for a whole year, they're not able to pay nothing. They exploit time, they come home without anything.
And your frustration is very high.
Yeah.
I'll be when I look at when I roll inside the COVID-19 fit and I want to set on the play part as IEM.